Well, good morning, Pete.
Good morning, Paul. How are you?
Well, yeah, I'm very well, thanks. Yes. Hopefully you are too.
Well, yeah, bit tired, but you know. This is...
So Pete has hot-footed it straight from a weekend festival at Nottingham to come and record this for us. So we're obviously very, very grateful. So if he falls asleep halfway through, we know exactly the reason why. But Pete, I just want to have a quick chat with you, if we can, about your career in general, what you get yourself up to.
Right.
Because you don't, I know a lot of these people watching will know you from the organ and keyboard world, but you do a lot outside that as well, don't you?
Yeah. You know, I mean, I started in the clubs in Manchester in 1975.
Wow.
When I was only three. Plus fat.
Yeah.
And, you know, I sort of had a career of playing in the clubs, backing the acts, you know, and then I went out as a cabaret act, you know, played in restaurants, piano. Obviously, then I went into the organ world. I worked in shops from 1977, selling organs, pianos, which was prolific business at that time. And so I had worked in the real great times, and then eventually I sort of started doing the festivals, and then that sort of linked me with the trade, with different various manufacturers. So yeah, I've had quite a varied 48 years on stage, which
well,
is
we go you know, back a fair way, ourselves, and ever since I've known you, you've always had Korg gear, both out live and in your studio, because I know you've got a very nice recording studio as well, and I've always seen Korg gear in there. What is it that appeals to
you? It's the sound, you know, it's the sound of different sounds in the banks, and just the way that the machine is put together. I bought my first ever Korg back in 1975, and you can only play one note on it at that time.
I can still only play one note, so that would be
and,
fine for me.
The strange coincidence is that particular model has just been re-released as a retro product, exactly the same, but in sort of digital format with a few extra bells and whistles. And I'd love one, actually. I would love one.
That's something Korg do an awful lot of, isn't it? Is to reintroduce, vintage.
Yeah, that's right. It's very popular, that, you know. They brought a Vox Continental out a few years ago, didn't they? You know, with some great organ sounds from the 60s and things like that. So, yeah, it's very interesting sort of a point in time where they're bringing these products back again, you know.
Yeah. So, obviously, you were brought up a little bit like I was, to a large extent, on electronic organ.
Yeah.
And now you use your Korg Pa5x, but you use it sort of like an organ, don't you?
Yeah, in like a modular organ.
Yeah, so what's your what's your current setup?
So current setup is obviously Pa5x 76 note keyboard, which is a great feel to play. Underneath, I use a Korg Nautilus 88, which is a weighted workstation, which has got some phenomenal pianos and orchestral instruments and obviously modern instruments as well. So the two marry up really sort of together. I don't actually MIDI them together. I just literally use them separate with separate volume pedals on the floor. And also I use the MIDI in a little way with the Nautilus to actually put the bass on my feet. So it's a bit like playing a sort of organ, organ with two keyboards, bass pedals on a metal stand for the gigs, you know.
I mean, obviously, we worked together, didn't we, when it was PA4X?
Yes, that's right. Yeah.
What do you love about the 5X over the 4X?
Well, obviously, the screen is much bigger.
Yeah.
It's a fabulous screen. I love the fact that these screens tilt as well.
Yeah.
Because I have seen keyboards in the past, especially if you're using one maybe in a room with strip lights or whatever, you can't see the screen if you've got any light.
Yeah.
So you can tilt this fantastically and get the perfect viewing angle.
Yeah.
The sound quality of both the styles and the sound bank is phenomenal. It's got full editing facilities for somebody like me, which is ideal. So if I want to make a nice string, orchestral string, you know, to my taste, it's very, very easy to actually just go into the menu and just adjust things.
I mean, to be honest, Pete, the way I look at the 5X is, you mentioned Nautilus, and before that it was Kronos.
That's right, yeah.
For anybody who's not heard of Kronos, Kronos became, in a way, the industry standard workstation. If you were to watch programs like Strictly Come Dancing, The Voice, I went to see Jane McDonald do a big Christmas show, MD, they're all playing Kronos. Yeah. Well, Kronos was replaced by Nautilus, and that's what Pete uses. Yeah. But there were sounds that were always the domain of those top pro guys on those workstations. Yeah. And now that technology genuinely is appearing in this product. And I think the gap between the pro workstation and the Arranger keyboard is now getting so small.
It is, yeah.
And you talked about the editing facility. I mean, the power of this thing,
it's incredible.
In terms of editing. Now, let that frighten you, because it doesn't mean you have to use all those features.
Yeah,
but for those who want to delve deeper into effects, voice editing, it's in there, isn't it?
Yeah, and I mean, you know, this weekend I've actually been working alongside the great Franz Lambert, who's technically renowned as the best organ player in the world as we speak. He's got gold discs.
Yeah,
he came to me, he watched the concert, and I couldn't believe how I felt as to what he said to me. And he just said, what a fantastic sound and technique you've got on these instruments. I have never seen you before. I've met you before. He said, I've never seen you before. That was absolutely stunning. And that was enough for me.
Now, actually, that will lead us in nicely, because what a lot of people watching will say is, that's all right for you, because you know how to create all these wonderful sounds. Yeah. And I think when we get any modern day keyboard, we know it's full of, let's call them, factory presets. Factory presets are good. All they are is a building block, because you can't please all of the people all the time.
You
tend to make things which are quite generic. So in other words, there'll be a set in there for a waltz, and the idea is you can play any waltz you like to it. So they haven't been over-processed, have they? Do their job.
Yeah, you know, I think this is the same with any manufacturer. You know, you get a set of factory presets, and then you can sort of build from there, as you said, building blocks and add certain effects and things.
But that brings us to your software that we're actually premiering on this online event, because we commissioned Pete to produce some software which would then be exclusive to Keysound customers. And I think I'm smiling slightly, because this began as, oh, well, it'll be a couple of weeks' work for you, Pete. 2 weeks in the hands of an absolute perfectionist became almost 4 months. And actually, when we were talking earlier, when Pete arrived, he's still doing little tweaks to it now as we speak, because he is the absolute perfectionist. But we'll go through what Pete has created for us. But you have worked as hard on these as you would on your concert performance pieces.
Yeah, it's exactly the same sound. You know, there's no difference in the quality of the sound of these presets than any concert that I would play. So they're exactly the same.
So if we were to give you an example, if we took something like a Shadows setting, Pete has chosen the right guitars and the right rhythm, but he's then looked at, could we edit the style a little bit? Would it be better with that guitar in for the Shadows than the other guitar? He's put the guitars through the relevant guitar amps, which you can do on here. He's put the right amount of delay and reverbs on them and absolutely honed it to perfection. And you've done that. How many registrations are there on it?
We've got 132 songbook entries, which means that there's a title for each of those.
Yes.
Some of them may say a title of a song.
Yeah.
You don't have to play that song.
No.
You know,
no.
You could play anything,
yes.
really, you know, you know, within that sort of genre and style.
Yeah. Yeah.
But within each of those songbook entries, you've actually got four registrations. So technically, you've got 132 songs times four registrations. So,
yeah.
you know, sort of 520... whatever it is, 528.
Anyway.
Yeah, so you know, you've got, and they're all titled as well.
Yeah.
So you know, if you go into a particular registration, go into the keyboard sets, and you can see what sound is in each of those four keyboard sets. Yeah.
And the beauty for you as a home player is we've tried to think of all the popular registration styles that people ask us for. So there's all sorts of big bands in there. You've got the Glenn Millers, you've got the Tommy Dorseys.
Yeah,
We've got things like Burt Camfort, we've got James Last, we've got the Shadows, we've got all sorts of different organ sounds, yeah. we've got pops orchestras, we've got symphony orchestras. You name it, it is in there, and it's all handed to you on a plate so that all you've got to do is select the relevant button and play and enjoy Pete Shaw quality sounds on your Pa5X. Well, it's been great having a little chat with you,
Thank
Pete.
Thank you, yeah.
And I'll get you a little coffee to keep you awake.
Yeah.
And then
yeah.
what Pete's going to do is go through, we haven't got time to go through all 130-odd registrations, but Pete's going to give you a selection of ones from each category that we've covered, and give you a sort of a wide spectrum of the sort of musical styles that we've covered. So, Pete, thank you very much for coming along.
No problem.
And we'll see you very shortly.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
Well, thanks very much indeed, Pete, for that little preview there of this brand new exclusive software. And that's important. This is exclusive to Keysound. If you want to know any more about the software, either give us a call. That's 0116 254 1053, or you can email us on sales@keysound.co.uk. I'll be popping those back up on the screen in just a second for you. Obviously, time doesn't permit for us to go through all of the settings that Pete's created, but what I thought we'd do now is give you a chance to have a look at all the screenshots of all the software that Pete has created. Bear in mind, each little tile that you see then contains four registrations or four keyboard sets for each of those boxes. It's an awful lot of software, and I'm sure when you look at the screens, you'll see there's a bit of something for everybody on there, and all the popular requested setups, they've all been done for you. It's also worth mentioning that there are quite a lot of new styles that come with that software, styles that you won't have had before on your Pa5X, so they will automatically load there as well. While you're watching these screens, you're going to hear another little performance by myself. And this is it has a link with Pete Shaw, who's just done that wonderful demonstration for us. I was looking to learn a new piece of music, and this piece was a hit for Ackerbilk. And no, it's not Stranger on the Shore. It's the other hit that he had, I believe, back in the 70s, a little piece called Aria. Beautiful piece of music. But could I find the music anywhere? So I picked the phone up and asked my very good friend Pete. And no sooner asked than done, because a few hours later, by email, came this lovely arrangement that he'd done. Pete has this great knack and this wonderful ability of being able to listen to a piece of music and actually write the score out as he's listening to the piece of music. Not just the melody line and the chords, Pete can pick out all the parts of the arrangement and score the whole thing out. So it was wonderful that he did that for me. So just to repay him for doing that, here is my arrangement of Pete Shaw's arrangement of Ackerbilk's arrangement of a little piece called Aria. Have a look at the screens that are on. That is all the categories and all the individual sections that Pete's programmed on that software. And don't forget, we'll be seeing Pete very, very shortly in a rerun of last Friday's concert with Pete and Steve Hubbell. So we're all looking forward to that a little bit later on. But for now, sit back, have a listen, and have a look at the full range of this new exclusive to Keysound PA5X software.